Hi guys, Terry Hansen here with Good Dog Coaching and Pet Care, and today I just want to take a few minutes to talk to you about the importance of keeping your dog's teeth clean and brushing them and how to do that, why it's important, and I'm actually going to demonstrate how simple it is to brush your dog's teeth. So first off, let's talk about why it's important. Dogs, just like humans, get tartar buildup on their teeth. Now, you know, when your dog's a puppy, their teeth are nice and white and bright, or maybe, you know, if you got a younger dog, they are as well. But over time, that tartar starts to build up and you can start to see it yellowing and, you know, you'll see it if you're looking in there. So the thing that's important to know about that tartar is that it's made up of about 80% bacteria. And it damages the gums, the bone beneath, and the ligaments that hold your dog's teeth in place. This bacteria can gain access to the bloodstream and infect vital organs like the heart, lungs, and kidneys. Furthermore, advanced dental disease hurts. This is not fun for your dog. It makes pets sick, and daily brushing is really the best deterrent. And it's so simple, really. You haven't ever brushed your dog's teeth, you know, it's just a process of teaching them to tolerate it. I mean, some dogs like it. There's toothpaste that tastes like chicken. So, you know, it really is a simple process. If your dog has bad breath, it might not just be doggy breath. It could be a sign that something is wrong, or it may be the result of the buildup of odor-producing bacteria in your dog's mouth, or their lungs, or even in their gut. So, persistent bad breath can indicate that your dog needs better dental care or that something is wrong in his gastrointestinal tract. So, always check with your vet if you notice a change in your dog's breath and to see if there's something else going on there. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure, for sure. So, brushing your dog's teeth every day or even three times a week can help you avoid costly teeth cleanings at the vet. So think about it. If you've ever had your dog's teeth cleaned, it can cost, you know, $100 to $200 by the time they get done with the blood, you know, the pre-blood work and all of that. And why put your dog through that if they don't need it? My dog Cole is 8 years old. She's never had her teeth cleaned. She's never needed her teeth cleaned. So she gets her teeth brushed on a regular basis. So with that being said, let me show you how simple it is to brush your dog's teeth. So first off, you're going to start off with, I mean, there's many products out there, first of all, let me just say that. They're from things that you can add to their water to things that you can spray on their teeth or in their mouth to actual doggy toothpaste. Yes. So I actually use a combination of a doggy toothpaste and then I also use a spray, and both of them have an enzyme in them that help to break down and kill the bacteria. So I like to do both. And you know, these products are not expensive and they save me a ton of money on having to take her in for a professional teeth cleaning. Not to mention, anytime your dog is sedated, there can be problems. So I like to avoid that at all costs. So anyway, she's down here sleeping. I'm gonna wake her up. A good girl, come over here. Seats. Come over this way where we can see you. Seats. Okay, good girl. So, toothbrush. They make doggy toothbrushes. Okay. I actually use just a small child's soft toothbrush. It's very simple. Put a little water on it and then a little bit of toothpaste. Just about a pea. Size of a pea, pea-sized amount on there, and you're going to very much, just like you would brush your own teeth, you're going to brush your dog's teeth. So if you're just teaching your dog to have their teeth brushed, you might get one that, this actually is a banana mint, and you might want to get one that smells like chicken or turkey or something like that. They have lots of flavors out there. So you want to just maybe put a little on your finger and let the dog lick it or taste it. And you know, if that goes well, then you can actually put a little on your finger and rub it in your dog's mouth, that kind of thing, just to get them started. Don't try to get in there right away with the toothbrush. Just get them used to that over the course of a few days. Then you can try with the toothpaste, let them smell it, let them check it out. And then, of course, you're going to want to hold their teeth, you know, their lips open. And you're just going to gently get in there and brush. You're going to do along the sides of your dog's teeth. I like to do it in like a little circular motion. You know, back and forth, just very gently, very gently. We're not trying to scrape anything off here. We're just very gently. And then, of course, their little canines. Their canines are not little, depending on the size of your dog. And, you know, just gently in little circular motion, brushing those canines. And then you want to get the little front teeth as well. And as you can see, Cole's a pro. Although she doesn't sit there and go cheese, but you know, she holds still. She's been doing this. She's used to this. And she gets this done, I'll say, almost every day, if we're being honest here. Sometimes I forget but you know, I really try and do it every day. And, again, like I said, show me your teeth. I mean, by the way, this is a great exercise for your dog, you know, being able to also allow you to handle them and their teeth. And, so here's Cole. Hang on one second. Hep, come here, give me those teeth. Teeth. All right. So we got nice, clean. She's 8 years old. You see how white those teeth are? Literally, that is from doggy teeth brushing. You know, there are products out there, teeth cleaning products. What I'm talking about are, you know, the greenies and things of that nature. Personally, you can use those things. Chew toys are great also for scraping off tartar, but really the toothpaste and the things that have the sprays and stuff that have the enzyme in them that kill the bacteria, it's my belief that they're really the best. I mean, I certainly give her chew toys, you know, Nyla bones, things of that nature. Even tug ropes and stuff are great for them to, you know, be chewing on and getting some of that plaque and tartar off their teeth. But these are the things that get in the places where the toys and the chew things can't get. So that's it. Pretty simple. You know, I always like to love her up and reward her afterwards and praise her for being so good. The main thing you want to remember is take it slow. Baby steps. If your dog's never had a toothbrush in their mouth or tasted doggy toothpaste, go very slow. Don't rush it. You want it to be a fun, positive experience. You don't even have to try and brush all of their teeth the first few times you do it. Just a little here, a little there, and over time, it might take a few weeks, but just be real patient. And your dog can do it, and it'll help them to be healthier and live longer. So if you have any questions, reach out to us at info@gooddogcoaching. Again, that's info@gooddogcoaching. Of course, you can check us out online on the web at www.gooddogcoaching as well. Happy to hear from you. Happy to answer any questions you might have. All right. Take care. Get out there and unleash the happy.